Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Fresh protests at the Gaza border against the Israeli siege and occupation. Evacuations continue in Afghanistan as aid agencies warn of starvation. Trial of West Papuan independence leader begins amid protests in Indonesia. New report finds Bahrain used Pegasus to hack into phones of activists. Algeria severs diplomatic ties with Morocco, citing hostile maneuvers. Hundreds of people held a protest near the city of Khan Yunis in Gaza on August 25th. The call was issued by several Palestinian factions against the ongoing Israeli siege. The blockade has already left 97% of Gaza's water undrinkable. Moreover, the repair materials needed for repair and reconstruction are not allowed to enter the enclave. Wednesday's protest followed another mass protest held near the Malacca refugee camp on August 21st. 41 Palestinians were injured during the protest along Gaza's eastern border as Israeli forces opened fire and shot volleys of tear gas. 32-year-old Osama Khalid Dia was among those shot. He died due to his injuries on August 25th. Israeli forces opened fire on protesters again on Wednesday. Drones loaded with tear gas were also flown over the area. As per latest updates, at the time of recording, at least 9 protesters had been wounded. Meanwhile, Palestinian and Israeli news channels have reported that Egypt has been pressuring Hamas to cancel protests. The country also shut down the Rafah border crossing with effect from August 23rd. The protests on Wednesday followed 2 days after Israel carried out another round of airstrikes on Gaza. Here is a video featured on the attack. UNICEF has warned that 10 million children in Afghanistan are in need of assistance. The World Food Programme has also stated that 14 million people are at risk of starvation. Livestock and crops have been destroyed after the war, a severe drought and the pandemic. Meanwhile, the US has stated that the withdrawal will not extend beyond August 31st. Over 82,000 people have been evacuated from the Kabul airport. However, footage shared from U.S. facilities in Qatar shows refugees being kept in brutal conditions. Hundreds of Afghans were crowded in unsanitary conditions at the Al Udeid airbase. Middle East Eye also reported that some refugees were refraining from eating and drinking so as to avoid using the unclean facilities. Meanwhile, the Taliban has stopped Afghans from reaching the Kabul airport. As per reports, checkpoints have been set and only those with a US visa, passport or an invitation can pass. Tens of thousands of Afghans have fled to the airport since last week. UN Human Rights Chief Michelle Bachelet said on August 24th that she had also received credible reports of summary executions. Independent UN experts have also reported door-to-door searches. The trial of West Papuan independence leader Victor Yemo began in Indonesia on August 24th. He is facing charges of treason and incitement for his alleged role in the 2019 anti-racism protests. The Indonesian government labeled the protests as riots, and paramilitary and armed forces were deployed. At least 30 people, most of whom were West Papuans, were killed. After the protests, the government arrested several activists, including Yemo, and charged them with high crimes. However, Yemo has stated that he was not a part of the protests in question. He is a member of the National Committee for West Papua, which is demanding self-determination for the Papuan people. If found guilty, he could face a prison sentence ranging from 20 years to life. There have also been serious concerns surrounding his health since his arrest on May 9th. Human rights lawyer Veronica Konam stated that Yemo has been held in isolation for 108 days. He was reportedly coughing up blood but was not given regular medical checkups. His lawyers had sought a postponement of the trial, however, that request was denied. Meanwhile, regular protests have been held in the Papuan provinces and major Indonesian cities demanding his release. These have been met with heavy repression, including the arrest of activists. Koman stated that a protester died after being shot on August 16. The use of excessive force, beatings and racial abuse by Indonesian forces has been documented. Another round of protests were held in Jayapura on August 24th. However, people were forcibly dispersed. 30 protesters were also briefly detained in Jakarta. Bahrain used the NSO group's Pegasus spyware to hack into phones of activists. At least 9 people were targeted, including 3 from the left-wing group WAAD. Others include 3 members of the Bahrain Center for Human Rights and 2 activists living in exile in the UK. A member of the Shiite Al-Wikaf party was also targeted. These findings are part of a report published by the Canada-based Citizen Lab. It argues that the hacking of activists living in exile means that Bahrain may have collaborated with another government. The government uses zero-click iMessages function of Pegasus to hack iPhones. It has previously also used internet controls and spyware from Finfisher and Hacking Team. Bahrain is among the dozens of countries found to be using the spyware in data made public under the Pegasus project. The NSO group claims that Pegasus is sold exclusively to states to fight crime and terrorism. However, data leaked by Amnesty and Forbidden Stories showed that activist lawyers and journalists were among those targeted. Algeria has cut diplomatic relations with neighboring Morocco, citing hostile maneuvers. The decision was announced on August 24th. Foreign Minister Ramdane Lamamra accused Morocco of using the Pegasus spyware against Algerian officials. Diplomatic ties between the two countries were restored in 1988. However, the border has remained closed since 1994. Tensions have flared surrounding Morocco's occupation of the Western Sahara. Algeria has supported the regional Polisario Front and self-determination for the people. It has also denounced the normalization deal between Morocco and Israel. As part of the deal, the US will recognize Morocco's claim over the Western Sahara. Foreign Minister Lamamra has stated that the consulates will remain open on both sides. Algeria had recalled its ambassador to Morocco in July. This was after a Moroccan official called for self-determination of the people in the Kabylie region. Algeria has labeled the movement for self-determination of Kabylie as terrorist organization. It has accused Morocco of supporting and financing the MAK. Algeria has also accused Morocco and the MAK of being involved in the recent wildfires in the northern region. And that's all we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website, peoplesdispatch.org. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.